ain't scaring nobody.
Ain't got no time to teach all you peckerwoods respect.
What do we have here? The idiot club?
I'll help you die. That's okay, what you want. Ain't got no time to teach all you peckerwoods respect.
You morons must be founder members.
You can rot!
See if we can get you on your feet.
Hands up now!
Do it! I ain't gonna repeat myself!
Hello. Mr. Morgan?
this.
All I'm saying, something happens, we get split up, we meet there. 01 Gila Dam, all right?
All right.
Josiah?
I was
leaving again?
Yes, just leaving. I'll see you soon.
Perhaps.
What do you mean?
Well, if I was you, I'd disappear too. This is all pretty much over.
But I'll be back.
No, you won't. Let's not pretend no more. Get out of here.
I'll miss you, Arthur. You've been a fine friend to me.
Oh, let's not get over sentimental. Oh, the place is quiet. Get out of here. You go with my blessing.
Thank you, Arthur.
Found a friend looking for you.
Mr. Morgan.
Sir.
How are you?
A little better.
I hope so.
How can I help you?
I am sorry to impose on you again, but I believe I've made progress brokering peace.
You have?
I believe so. Colonel Favors has agreed to a meeting to discuss and maybe resolve his alleged grievances and mine. Now, he has lied to me more times than I care to remember, but maybe this time he must want peace. Why could he possibly want to humiliate us further?
Well, we got words for his kind, but they're colloquial.
Perhaps I could make one last request. My men are not allowed to carry arms.
You want us to keep the peace?
Yeah, it'll be a lot of dull talking and ceremony. But I feel with some non-tribe members present, their chances of lying or worse will be reduced.
Will you, Arthur?
It ain't my business, brother.
No, I know. But it is mine. Do it for me.
Charles, I got...
I've saved your life. Do it for me.
Sure. Come on. You owe this man. You should have him do your negotiation.
Let's go.
Wait. Come on, let's get it. Yep.
This way. I also have some men meeting me there. I wasn't sure if you'd be able to help. Thank you for doing this, both of you. You have already done so much.
Ain't a problem. Just hope nobody recognizes me. I've had a few run-ins with the army recently.
I wish...
more to control the situation. That shouldn't have gotten involved. Now Eagle Flies is under arrest.
It certainly won't help our case today.
I will find a way to help it. I promise you.
I just hope Colonel Favors can be reasoned with. I am not asking for very much, but when our people are sick and hungry, and we find our medicine and supplies are being deliberately withheld, how can we not view that as something personal? When they destroy our sacred sites, how can I convince Eagle Flies and the others that they shouldn't fight back?
Maybe that's part of the reason they're doing these things. Because they want you to fight. Be able to say, look, you see how these savages behave?
Perhaps. Thank you for helping Captain Monroe to retrieve those vaccines, Arthur. He will be at the meeting and is one person who knows the true situation, at least. I still have hope that we can come to an agreement. line up ahead.
Hello.
Hold. We chasha kena na kula wichiampi hiopo unyapi ktelo. This way. Over this way. Is there a problem, Mr. Morgan?
Colonel Favors, Captain Munro, we come in peace.
Hello again. Who are these two?
They're friends of my people.
Hmm. Interesting looking fellows.
Yeah, they won't cause any trouble.
Well, I should hope not. Listen, Mr.
Chief.
Yes, Mr. I can't say that silly name.
In English, they call me Rainsfall.
Yes, yes, I'm sure they do. Listen, we're all Americans here, and we want an outcome. But quite frankly, I'm confused. Your men are little more than criminals, in my opinion. Keep breaking peace treaties we've made. Causing disturbances in everybody's lives. But I pride myself on being a gentleman. Really, I do. But there are limits. So, let me be very... Are you okay, man? Someone. Jackson, take him away. Where was I?
You're a gentleman with limits?
Are you being facetious, sir?
Come this way, buddy.
I said... Are you being facetious, Captain Munro?
No, sir, I am not.
Chief Rains.
That's, Rains' fault.
Exactly. Chief Rains, the thing
is... It's quite
is,
a cough.
Federal government.
Sure.
Wait here. Situation. I'll fetch you some water.
I'll be fine. Thank you.
No, no. You know he's going to have Munro court-martialed. Or attempt to. He's going to make a disgrace of him.
Munro? Seems likable enough for a West Pointer. Why?
You know what Favors is like. Because he thinks it's right. Because he thinks Munro is a patsy. Or a spy. He's convinced he had something to do with those vaccines getting stolen. He thinks Munro is going to force him into making a concession with the Indians. So he removes Munro.
Removes how?
Favors wants him tried for treason. And hanged.
Why does Favors care about the Indians?
Because he doesn't want to back down. His whole professional life. You know what they say about him. Hightail Favors. The man who missed a battle.
Poor Munro. Kind of liked him.
I know. Well, still, he's kind of stuck up.
Your men violated the treaty. That treaty is null and void. I have been appointed to negotiate.
Feeling better?
Yeah. Come on. Let's go.
The lands you currently occupy belong to the United States government. Why is this so confusing, sir? Why?
Good day, Colonel Favors.
Well, that was remarkably unproductive.
So?
I'm afraid the federal government was quite clear, Colonel, that it wanted peace, and peace for all, and that the treaty had not been broken by anybody.
Oh, is that so, sir? And did it want impudence, sir, from a junior officer in public? Was that its plan too, sir? You insult me. You insult the regiment. Arrest this man.
Arrest me?
Gross insubordination. Disobeying an order. Treason.
Are you mad?
You had those vaccines stolen. You disrupted a negotiation.
Let him go.
This is all getting out of hand.
Aye.
Captain Monroe, let's get out of here.
Aye,
if I were you, I'd keep my mouth shut, amigo. I don't want to kill this man, but shall.
You won't get away with this.
Charles, Captain Monroe, mount up now. We're getting out of here.
I'll kill you.
Open fire!
What do we do now?
You get out of here. Fast. Take you to the station.
I can't believe that just happened. I've been an army man my whole life.
I heard them talk. They was gonna have you hang for treason. You can't die for those fools.
And what about the chief?
We'll do what we can.
I guess I won't be submitting my report.
I wouldn't think so. Captain Monroe?
I fear it may be Mr. Monroe from now on.
I'm sorry about your career. Here. Here's some money. You take it and get out of here and start a new life somewhere. I hear Tahiti's nice.
Thank you.
Just hop on a train to San Denis, jump on a boat, but avoid Guam.
Where?
Forget about it.
Meet me at the reservation.
Mr. Morgan! Are you okay?
Well, never better. What are you doing here?
Well, I'm on my way down to Mexico. They're finally sending me on a mission. Brother Dorkins is very jealous. What's wrong?
I'm dying, sister.
Okay.
Yeah, I got TB. I got it. Beating a man to death for a few bucks. I've lived a bad life, sister.
We've all lived bad lives, Mr. Morgan. We all sin. But I know you.
You don't know me.
Forgive me, but that's the problem. You don't know you.
What do you mean?
I don't know, but whenever we happen to meet, you're always helping people and smiling.
I had a son. He passed away. I had a girl who loved me. I threw that away. My mama died when I was a kid. And my daddy, well, I watched him die. And it weren't soon enough.
My husband died a long time ago. Life is full of pain. But there is also love and beauty.
What am I gonna do now?
Be grateful that for the first time, you see your life clearly.
Sure.
Perhaps you could help somebody. Helping makes you really happy.
But I still don't believe in nothing.
Often, neither do I. But then I meet someone like you, and everything makes sense.
You're too smart for me, sister. I guess I'm afraid.
There is nothing to be afraid of, Mr. Morgan. Take a gamble that love exists and do a loving act.
All aboard!
I shall try.
I know you will. Goodbye. Goodbye, Mr. Morgan. Goodbye.
Sister.
fighting in here. You keep that up and I'll boot you out of here myself.
You trying to annoy me, friend?
Listen closely. If you can't act right, then get... I guess that.
Morning, friend.
Is that it?
Morning.
How's it going?
I guess that's that.
Yep. see you.
Another day.
Morning. You okay?
All this whispering and walking on eggshells, I hate it.
Mrs. Adler.
You okay?
Peachy.
You sure?
No, I ain't sure.
You still working?
Is anybody still working? The whole goddamn place full of people bickering, fighting, and lying. It makes me real sad.
I know. I need someone to ride with me.
Do what?
Finish off them O'Driscolls. I hear the last of them is holed up at Hanging Dog Ranch.
I don't have it in me no more. I saw Colm swing. I just don't care.
I was a married woman. You know what they did to me. And to my husband? You're the only one of these fools that I trust. I've got to do this.
I'll tell you what. I'll do it. But there's something you could help me with. Abigail. Jack. John. Make sure they make it. I mean, this whole thing is pretty much done. But when the time comes...
But how do you mean...
When the time comes, you help them.
What do you mean?
I mean, help them escape. When I... You know, you and me, we're more ghosts than people. But them, they could...
I know. Of course I will. Thank you, Arthur. You want to ride with me now, or meet me up at Hanging Dog Ranch when you can? Thanks, Arthur. Okay, come on.
Fine morning for killing.
Hey.
You seen anything down there?
Yeah, I think there's a bunch of them down there. I'm mostly drunk. But one of them is a fat fellow with a beard. Him? He's mine.
Okay.
It's a big ranch. Run down. Lots of folk there. But spread pretty thin. I'll set it off and then we'll We'll take it from there.
Take it from there? Okay. So, no real plan then.
Oh, I got a plan. Now come on. He was a good man, my Jakey. We was always sweet on one another.
I'm sure.
Yeah. I miss him every day, every moment. They turned me into a monster, Arthur. But my memories of him, they still pure.
I ain't even got that.
Aside from my Jake, you're the best man I've known.
I know the company you keep. The competition ain't too fierce.
We should get away from her.
I think I need to be alone for a bit.
I understand. You, might want to get yourself cleaned up.
Thank you, Arthur.
Yeah!